My training wheels are broken. I'm not stable. I'm not ready. Whenever I get nervous, I get gone, so you don't get nervous. You like that I like Lego and building, but I break things. And smiling is something you're good at. It makes me feel okay. 'Cause you don't know that's apparent.
It's not hard to see.
You seem delusional,
just optimistic,
but I kinda like it. You don't know
that's apparent.
It's not hard to see.
You seem delusional,
just optimistic,
but I kinda like it.
I don't think I'm that pretty. I'm normal, but you're special. You're curious and patient. You make things seem different. You don't feel good, so you try to make me feel good. And smiling something you're good at, it makes me feel okay. 'Cause you don't know
that's apparent.
It's hard to see.
You seem delusional,
just optimistic,
but I kinda like it.
You
don't know
that's apparent.
It's hard to see.
You seem delusional,
just optimistic,
but kinda like it.
What's happening, folks? My name is Jamie Watson. I'm a singer-songwriter that has been in Bath, England for the past 4 years, but now I'm back in my home country of Northern Ireland, back in Belfast. So it's all good in the hood over here. That song you just heard was an original of mine called You Don't Know Me. It's on everywhere you get music, Spotify, Apple, whatever you're looking for, it's all there. And it also features my friend Megan Clemens. Her lovely voice is on it also. So go check that out. But I'm glad that Leyla asked me to do this little virtual festival. It's a great idea. So thank you, Leyla, for having me. But I thought I'd kind of take you on a little journey of where I am right now and how I got here. So I like came up through the kind of pub singer scene. So I was playing a lot of bars in Belfast and that kind of thing, a lot of covers gigs. And a few years ago, as I said, 4 years ago, decided to go to England to study music. And now I've got a master's in commercial music now, so that's great. But a lot of what I came from is thanks to me playing a lot of pub gigs. And this next song I'm going to play for you is a song by my favorite band ever, Bowling for Soup. This is a song called Two Seater. And the reason I love it is because it's such a non-typical kind of breakup song. It's like, it's left field in that it's so real and honest, but it's like I think it's the most honest a person can be about a breakup and how petty people can be. So this is how it goes.
I wanna wake up in your arms, I wanna set off your alarms, and I wanna break into your car, and I wanna take out the back seat. One way to tell me everything I thought I always wanted to hear. One way to tell me that it's over. So every time you look in your rearview mirror, I hope you see me. And all the stuff I did when we were back here together, oh, hope you like your two-seater. No radio, your K-marks parallel to the pinstripes. Your windows are broken, your T-top stolen, now it's one of a kind. Thanks for the ride. And I gotta get the hell out of Dodge. Just spent the whole night avoiding the cops, and I just don't think I'll go to the clink just cause I took out the backseat. And that's where it taught me everything I thought I always wanted to hear. That's where it taught me that it's over. But every time you look in your rearview mirror, I hope you see me. And all the stuff we did when we were back here together, oh, hope you like your two-seater. No radio, the key marks parallel to the pinstripe. Your windows are broken, your T-top stolen, now it's one of a kind. Thanks for the ride. Can you hear your radio? I bet you can't hear your radio. So you'll never know I wrote this song for you. I'm sorry that your tires are flat. No, you really weren't expecting that. I guess I got a little carried away. So when you look in your rearview mirror, I hope you see me there. I hope you like your two-seater. No radio, key marks parallel to the pinstripes. T-top stolen, now it's one of a kind. Thanks for the ride. No radio, two-seater. No radio, two-seater. No radio. Thanks for the ride.
Some Bowling for Soup for you. I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. I just think it's a great song. And the particular pub I played in, it's now like a Peaky Blinders inspired pub, but it used to be called the Hudson. And there was, Bowling for Soup were playing Belfast one time. This is when I left Bath, but they happened to go into that pub. The day that I was seeing him that night in Belfast, because I flew back. It was during a holiday. But oddly enough, the staff at that bar requested they play that song because they don't usually play it live. So, like, when I was standing at the front, I literally went there on my own to see them. But I heard from the back, like, play two-seater! And it was the staff from the pub that I used to play in, which is, it just seemed really outrageous that me, like, my favourite band ever went to the pub I used to play in for, like, open mics and got my first kind of paid gigs up. So it's just like a small world. But it kind of made me think about making my own band myself. And when I was at uni, I did that. I formed a band called Manus Parlo with three other guys. And it was kind of like kind of alternative rock. We like to mix a lot of things into it. But we have a three-track EP out. We've kind of disbanded now, but maybe in future we'll release some of the songs we also had, who knows. Probably not, don't get your hopes up, but I'm still proud of those three songs we put out anyway. And this is one of them. This is called Hello to Say Goodbye, which is the final track on that three track, and it goes like this.
If the morning car, would you feel compelled to answer? Tell me all your lies, don't think it really matter to you. No, don't feel like I'm running or afraid of being hurt. Just careful of exposing my deeper layer of dirt. But it's nice to see a new face and live a brand new life. The problem is a glass half full won't feel a well run dry. Excuse me, please sit for a while. What's your name? We can stay the night. You feel alright, your friends seem nice. I said hello to say goodbye. Is it holding on? It's easy. I said hello to say goodbye. Is it holding on? It's easy to be alone. I don't think you're understanding my choice to live this way. When distance feels so close, it's perfect for keeping thoughts in place. A wedding flashes from the phone screen that stirs my wildest dreams. If all you offer is reaction, then keep your thoughts from me. Excuse me, please sit for a while. What you make is stay the night. You feel alright, your friends seem nice. I said hello and say goodbye. Best it holding on, it's easy. I said hello and say goodbye. Best it holding on, it's easy. Thank you.
it for a while, but your name can stay the night. You feel alright, your friends seem nice. I said hello to say goodnight. I said holding on, it's easy. I said hello to say goodnight. I said holding on, it's easy. I said it holding on, it's easier to be alone.
There you go, with some Manus Parlo for you folks. Go check out that EP of ours. It's three tracks, so I suppose it's more like a single, but it's an EP. They're all different tracks. But yeah, get the streams up for that, even though it's not a band anymore. But go check it out, because we're proud of it. But I found that when I was writing all these songs, and when I was developing my own kind of, at least my own kind of lyrical identity of what I like to write about, there was a lot of vulnerability and kind of explicit honesty with dealing with kind of the worst parts of what we think about. And that's where I think I fell into my kind of lyrical niche. And I think that maybe comes down to the influence of a songwriter called Jason Isbell, who used to be guitarist of a band called Drive-By Truckers, but has moved on to do his own quite successful solo career in the country / Americana circuit. And there was this song that he released in 2013, I believe. And it had such an overwhelming impact on me. And it's called Elephant. I just thought that's such a raw song that it's just hard not to feel something when he's singing this song, because it's like deals with like kind of ideas of cancer and stuff, and how you deal with the journey of that. It goes like this: 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
Past, winked at me and drank in a glass, cross-legged on a bar stool like nobody sits anymore. She said Andy would take me home, but I knew she planned to sleep alone. I'd carry her to bed and sweep up the hair from the floor. If I'd fucked her before she got sick, I'd never hear the end of it. But she don't have spirit for that now. So we drink our drinks and laugh out loud and bitch about the wicked crowd and try to ignore the elephant somehow. She said, "Andy, you cracked me up. Seagrams in a coffee cup, sharecropper eyes and a hair almost all gone." She was drunk, she made concert jokes, made up her own doctor's notes,
surrounded by family, saw that she was dying alone.
Now I'd sing her classic country songs, and she'd get high and sing along. But she don't have a voice to sing with now. So we burn these joints in effigy and cry about what we used to be, and try to ignore the elephant somehow. Yeah, we try to ignore the elephant somehow. I buried her 1,000 times, giving up my place in line, but I don't give a dime about that now. There's one thing that's real clear to me: no one dies with dignity. We just try to ignore the elephant somehow. We try to ignore the elephant somehow. Somehow.
That's some Jason Isbell for you. Now, I don't think that... I wouldn't say I'm a country artist. I don't think a lot of what I write would be considered country, or at least not for the most part the kind of pop country that people usually refer to now. But that's not to say it hasn't influenced a lot of my songwriting. I always grew up with country music, kind of Garth Brooks, Alan Jackson and stuff. So it just kind of passed down a lot to me, because that's what my parents listened to and their parents listened to. But there was... I think there's a lot of good stuff coming out of that world at the minute. You got Jason Isbell, as I said. Chris Stapleton is great. Midland, if you know who Midland are doing bits. And then the kind of wider Americana as a whole. There's some great stuff there, but that kind of world influenced this next song that is a song of mine, which would be the B-side of a single I'm releasing quite soon. And it's called Before We Turn Cold. And the kind of single, the A and B side, is basically my farewell to living in England, in Bath, specifically. I made a lot of friends there I'm still in contact with, and I hope I will remain in contact with, but I kind of personified my time there. And I made a few numbers.
Why can't you see? Not who you need. I'm tired, but you're free to do as you please. But I keep a photo from when you sheltered me. So I'll take my stones to lighten your load. So let's make one more memory before we turn cold. Is this love that we share was always touch and go. Is sinking, the other still flows. You said that you trust me. That was the joke, but I would still bet. So let's make one more memory before we turn cold. 'Cause this love that we shared was always touch and go. This love that we shared was always touch and go.
Well, there's some Jimmy Watson country Americana vibes for you. Hope you enjoyed that. But another thing I learned is that I love, well, that particular song was more of a hook than a chorus, but a lot of my writing and a lot of what draws me to songs is a big chorus, you know, a big anthemic chorus. And this next song I'm going to do is a cover, and the reason I choose this is because it has one of those anthemic choruses, but it reminds me of a time when I was younger and I was at a youth club, and we had this youth worker, his name was Lee, and he always used to just sing this song randomly. He just loved it at the time, and it always kind of brightened my day a little bit. So I've got a special place in my heart for this song. Here's Angels by Robbie Williams.
I sit and wait. Does an angel contemplate my fate? And do they know the places where we go? Gray and old, 'cause I have been told that salvation lets their wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts running through my head, feel that love is dead, I'm loving angels instead. And through it all, she offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong. And tell me why to fall. God's a call, she won't forsake me. Loving angels instead. When I'm feeling weak, in my pen walks down a one-way street. I look above and I know I'll always be blessed with her. As the feeling grows, she brings flesh to my bones. And when love is dead, I'm loving angels instead. And through it all, she offers me protection, a lot of love and affection. Whether I'm right or wrong, it's hell no waterfall. She won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead.
What a tune. Like, how can you beat some Robbie? But this kind of moves me on to my last track for you folks. Because, well, I'm only human. Sometimes I wish I wasn't human. I wish I wasn't really real. And that's kind of the... kind of the gist of this next song, in terms of, like, rather being fictional than real. The idea that you'd want to be... the idea that you want to be a character in a book rather than in your own life. A novel, a fantasy. And this song is called Write Me in a Book. Write me in a book. 'Cause I don't like my current situation. The world won't bend the knee to the flesh upon my bones. We'll hear the thoughts I have, say they're scary. But in a book you can interpret what I mean. Description. lots of details.
Paint a picture that you want the world to see. Write me in a book. Let me explore a brand new world. You think I live in, but you describe my eyes as a greeny shade of blue. But do you just see red, an angry spectrum? Book, I can't interpret what you see. So write me in your book that you will elaborate it on how you think I'm feeling. Will you paint me as a villain of the tale? Lots of details. Paint the picture that you want the world to see.
Thank you everyone for listening. I've been Jimmy Watson. Thanks again, Leyla, for setting us up. Peace and love, everyone. Enjoy your day.